Hello students, this is worksheet 5 of chapter 9. Today we will do worksheet 5 of chapter 9 and chapter 10. So in this worksheet 5 of chapter 9, the first part is very easy. I hope all of you will be able to do this. 5 into 5 is how much you know. That is equal to 20 plus which number will be equal to 5 into 5. 6 into 4 is how much you will write here. 5 plus 5 plus 5, 4 times 5 added. This can also be written as 5 into 4, isn't it? So this is very easy. Next is spot the error. This is the most interesting part that you enjoy. Now the first question here is, Prakash made a number skip using skip counting. Find the mistakes he has made. Also correct it. Now skip counting, you know children, the difference between each number, the difference between the two numbers will be same. 5 plus 5 is 10, again 10 plus 5 is 15. So here the difference of 5 is given. 5 numbers are skipped and the next number is written in the next box. So there is a mistake over here. I hope by this time all of you have seen the mistake. In this line, you will write the correct numbers that the number skip should have. And the number two, the next question is, Joseph counted 20 cherries from the picture below and wrote the multiplication statement. Spot the error he has made. Now see how many cherries are there, okay? He wrote it as 9 into 2, 20. So let us count how many groups are there. We can see there are 2 in each group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Then this much he has done correct, that there are 9 groups. And he wrote it 9 into 2. But is 9 into 2 equal to 20? Then you have to write it correctly in the next line. Now let us move to worksheet 5 of chapter 10. This is worksheet 5 from chapter 10. Over here also the first part is very easy. Some simple addition and subtraction using money. And number 4 is, which is greater, you have to tell that rupees 15 is greater or rupees 50 is greater. These are very easy, children. This is spot the error. Again, an interesting thing to be done. Jaya bought a pen for rupees 5 and an eraser for rupees 4. She gave a rupees 10 note to the shopkeeper. The shopkeeper returned her rupees 2. Did the shopkeeper return the correct amount? You have to make a very simple and easy calculation and find out whether the shopkeeper has returned her the correct amount or not. If yes, then tick on yes. If no, then tick on no. And if you think it is not correct, then you will write the correct amount the shopkeeper should have returned in this blank. Number 2 is, Mr. Khan counted the coins and wrote it rupees 25. You can see here 4 5 rupees coins given. Mr. Khan counted it and wrote it as 25. Did he write the amount correctly? Yes or no? If you think it is no, then you will tick mark on, you will put a tick on no and you will write the correct amount the coins value is. You will write the total value of the coins. So this much for today.